stormy day in Parliament, which ended with the Prime Minister asking everyone to introspect and look at varying views. And on this day, that crores, it's been day three of Parliament, crores have gone wasted. I have on agenda three MPs of three different parties, Udit Raj of the BJP, MB Rajesh of the left, and the Congress's Sushmita Dev. Two of them, of course, the other side, they have been protesting. The BJP, of course, has its own protest. And of course, audience we have from IP College, Delhi University, and other students of Delhi University who are going to be taking questions, asking tough questions of our MPs. And before I actually ask all of you about what happened today and how you justify that such disruption and so much money being wasted, I just wanted to ask all the students here, when the MPs over here say the opposition stays, that first we have resignations and then we will come to the house, and the other side says no, first let's have debate, is there anyone who has an opinion who thinks a particular side is right? You wanted to say, yeah, go ahead.
I think that the MPs should come and debate first. They should be given an opportunity to put their point of view first. Because if you ask them to resign, that would lead to another question that would come up. What next?
Is there anyone who feels differently? No one. So I think the first question should go to Sushmita Dev and to MB Rajesh. They feel that you should debate first. Your insistence on the resignations first is something that a lot of people don't understand. Do you want to elaborate?
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead, Rajesh. Yeah.
Actually, what is the logic of demanding a resignation from the minister who is facing corruption charges? The logic is that when investigations are going on against his or her, against that minister, she or he should not remain in power. Because if an investigation agency which is under a government, which is the minister is part of that government, that investigation will not be free and fair. So that is the logic of demanding a resignation. Our position, CPIM's position, is that yes, please remove the minister from the post and let's have a fair and free investigation. Then if the if it is found that the minister is not guilty, then she or he can come back.
And you won't come back to the house?
I want to object here that he is accused, he is not guilty. Then first of all, we should have debate first so that he or she has the right to speak her mind, because they end up being silent.
I want to respond. When the same kind of allegations came, I would like to quote Mr. Arun Jaitley, the current finance minister and who was the leader of opposition in Rajya Sabha at that time. He said that a debate is not a substitute for a free and fair investigation. Is that logic is not applicable today?
See, what Arun Jaitley has said, that at that time it was a different scenario. Now BJP is saying that Sushma Swaraj has a lot to say about the scams, but until unless Congress or the opposition wouldn't allow it, how can one appoint the people of this country know what's really happening?
You share the same
I think conceptually they are not clear about
the
what
left.
Has happened. No.
The government.
On the objections they are raising, look, I completely agree. When it is an allegation, everybody, even politicians, non-politicians, our criminal justice system says that you are innocent until you are proven guilty.
Okay.
Correct?
Yeah.
Now, two things flow from that. Let's say I am the human resource development minister, okay, and I am lying about my college degree. Now, when an investigation will start, who will get called? Who will get called against me? Somebody who is working under my ministry in some university? So are you telling me an ordinary employee of any central university or open university, it will not cross his mind even once that if I were to speak the truth and if it goes against my minister, what will happen? Number two, Sushma Swaraj has made three statements in the public domain. One, she has admitted she has helped Lalit Modi. Her justification for it, that's up to her, right or wrong, she says on humanitarian grounds. Two, she has admitted her daughter is the lawyer for Lalit Modi. All admissions, these are not allegations. Three, she has admitted...
She wants to say more, Sushmita.
Let me finish.
Okay.
Because he made a very fine and a distinguished argument that you must have a chance to defend yourself. She has made three admissions in public. We've seen it on Twitter. We've seen it repeatedly on television. So now the question is, surely she has something more to say.
Yeah.
That is your excuse. Now the question is, what more can you say? You said what you have done and you said why you have done it. What is the third thing that she has to say?
All ordinary citizens get a chance to defend themselves in court. And why not ministers?
Okay, you are not satisfied with what the MP said.
Sushma Swaraj wants to say something about Congress leaders who has asked her to filter for the passport issue of one of the tainted Congress leaders.
Okay.
So, I mean, that's why Congress not letting her
speak. I wanted to ask Mr. Udit Raj. Obviously, this audience, the ones who are speaking up, they are more on your side of the thing because they are saying, let's have the debate. Because even Aam Janta is saying, why are they wasting our money? They should at least start. Then we talk about the, as all of these audience members say.
They are not only on our side, but they are a side of truth. So they are speaking the truth.
But sir, now you are also disrupting.
Listen.
Yeah.
Truth. What happened is that, number one, can they prove it that she has benefited him economically? Number one. Number two, is she responsible that he became fugitive? He went, he escaped from India? No. Number three, she has just said that it's not recommendation, it's advisory in nature.
Okay.
It was not recommended to
okay.
him, but advisory in nature
okay.
that since her, his wife is.
Yeah, I don't want to, I don't think we should get bogged down by the merits of each case. Yeah.
No,
because
yes.
we are talking clear about destruction, and
let
it's justified.
Let me further.
Yeah.
And there is no corruption, no criminality. And
no, sir,
listen,
if you want to argue
then,
on merits,
then entire CRPC has to be changed. And that has to be checked according to their convenience.
Yeah.
But that is not the rule of law.
Sure, sir.
CRPC is
sir,
there.
My question
CRPC is there.
Okay.
Law is there. Unless person is proved guilty,
yeah.
you can't hang that person. And of course, when we are ready to debate on the floor,
yeah.
what best can be?
Sure, sir. I get that point.
Should,
sir, can I ask
should,
one thing?
Yeah.
You, the BJP has been pointing out that the politics of disruption won't work, that you're blaming them for the disruption. But do you think that today you decided that you will beat them at their own game by also having posters in the house, taking up the Wadra issue, or is that different from the protests that they are doing? How is that different?
Enough is enough. We will not bear much. And it has been going on one side.
Okay.
Do they have a license to disrupt the proceedings?
Yeah.
To cause to the nation?
Okay.
And make frivolous allegations which are not founded?